Hello everyone, and today we're gonna try to restore the technology we had before. And let's start with official version of history. Okay, you spend 5 or 10 tons of pure bronze, you take 100 or 200 horses to deliver it to the castle you wanna siege, and what happens? Almost nothing. You hit it, fire with stone ball and see what happens. Stone ball is destroyed completely. You use shitty powder, not even good one, and you cannot even hit people. And what happened? It's a real shot from real gun, real cannon, ancient cannon. And you see what happens? It takes 2 time to make a hole in a bunch of only simple bricks, even without mortar. It's not even wall, just a bunch of bricks put together. But how this one worked? You see, some of them cannot work officially. Really, just take a look how this one can shoot and kill somebody. This one, let's see, 5-10 tons of bronze and no sign of installing it somewhere. Only something to hang up. And this one is too long to use this shitty powder we had. And this one looks like bell. Really, doesn't look like a normal cannon. And this kind of weapon also not for picking each other, you know. It's something special. And if we know that it's something different, we can take a closer look and try to find another way to use this one, for example. How this one could shoot twice, you know. Also, it's a very strange shape. Not for powder, definitely. It doesn't look like it's for powder. And this pinch in the end, this, how to say it, ball. And it's everywhere. The same design in many countries in Asia. This one in Sumatra, in Indonesia, in Vietnam, and so on. Not only in Western countries, this one we find in Malaysia. All countries had the same design. Isn't it strange for you? Don't you think it's strange? Guys, try to think. Maybe there is something else. And this design of ending, also a bit strange. A little bit. Very old photo show us very strange design. And this happens if they try to use powder, gun powder, to shoot. It just breaks in the middle because it's strange shape. It's not even cylinder. And this one is too big to be delivered on the battlefield, to be used in battlefield. And there is no way this one could be used with gun powder. There are many of them. Very strange shape, design, and so on. They definitely could not be used with gunpowder. Just think about it. And no original carriages. And this one also a little bit strange. 2 thick walls, and so on. And this doesn't look like cannon at all. And they all were has traces of deformation from this side. This is how officially they used for shooting. But there is no way it can be used with gunpowder because gunpowder will break like this one. Yes, especially with stone balls or with any cannonballs. It's a ball, it can be stuck. And this one also cannot be used official way. And design a bit strange. It's not necessary for cannonballs, for gunpowders and so on, to have this thing in the bottom, in the beginning of a cannon. And this one also could not be used as cannon. And definitely there is no design, no way it can be directed left or right, moved to aim better. Just look at the strange design of some strange cannons. It's everywhere in the world. Very strange shapes. And my idea is, my point is, let's try to find out what do we have in official sources, in some books, in some other materials and design of other antique stuff, to find out what's going on and how it was used. Official sources, I mean official books, tell us something like the same. Something like this, with explanation, with all devices, how it's named and so on. And it's very, very strange that all this deck, all these rings and balls are called, and parts of the cannon is called like notes, you know, like in music, we have notes. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si, so on. Yeah, parts of it. And a little bit strange that there is no powder, gunpowder. It's no description, explanation how to use. And this using of cannon is a little bit strange. And also, if we know about some other kind of weapons, which are used almost like a musician instrument, we can find out something special. We can make another decision, another conclusion of how the cannons were used. It's just a hypothesis, just an idea, but if we know that some weapons were using some kind of energies to be operated, we can also assume, make a hypothesis that cannons were also used with some energies and some laws of physics we have no idea of. And if we assume it, I think we can try to find another way of using cannons. I mean, maybe the same way, but using the different laws of physics. You see, it's too small cannonball for such a huge diameter. Diameter was too big, and the way they put balls together also a little bit strange. Cannonballs are too small, and cannonballs made of stone, it's a bit strange. And bronze, using bronze, not metal, not steel, it's also a little bit strange. I think that even if we know that all books in 19th century are faked, we can assume that people who are making such fakes knew something about a real way of using cannonballs, and not everything is a liar there. So I think something is true, and if we know it, let's try to find out the real thing, some true material, and let's try to do it. We know that cannons were hanged using those devices. We know that first pictures, people didn't know how to use cannons, no borders, only cannonballs everywhere. And first photos show us the destruction which cannot be made by conventional weapons of that time. Cannons were everywhere, so it's real cannon for bottles and so on, but they were not used to shoot people, because we don't see any photos of cannon of operation, and very strange destructions. So how they were used? Because people didn't know how to use it, they use it in all ways. It doesn't look like correct, right way of using of weapon. If it's a dangerous weapon, you cannot use it as a fence or something. Once again, cannonballs everywhere and cannons everywhere, and nobody is using it. Nobody thinks that it's kind of weapon or something. Nobody thinks that it's dangerous or something, like we see in the first photos of so-called Independence War in the USA, or in some photos of Paris in Franco-Prussian War. I mean, it's a fake wars, cover stories, and if people try to use it using gun pointer, we saw this picture. Something like this. It was broken. And first photos, people were just posing with close to cannons, but no ways people were using it. And people of two types of heights, I mean 2 and 4 meters, they also were still alive there that time. And if we know all together, let's try to put puzzle. See the picture, because this is real cannon in real German museum, army museum. And they use spaghetti to kill people, or what? Why in 1817 we had such spaghetti cannons and cannons no one could use, and in 20 years we had something like this? Totally different process, metallurgy, different material, steel, different sizes, different ways of ignition, capsule system to ignite it from inside to have high pressure to avoid leaking and so on, just different way. Look what we had in 1870, and after 20 years we had this. This is first video, but first photos show us the same. Just 20 years and we changed everything, the complete new paradigm of using artillery in battlefields and completely different technologies. What the hell happened within 20 years? Only for 20 years. Guys, don't you think it's a bit strange? What I mean is, it takes about 20 years only to build a plant. I mean, it's not enough time just to educate people, give them new education, prepare equipment, find the process, find suppliers of good steel, and so on. You see, some people try to use the same technologies like we are told to make a cannon of 17th century in Sweden. And what they did? Yes, they could make something, but they had to put pipe, steel rod, steel pipe to shoot it, because otherwise gunpowder destroys the cannon. But how this cannon could be used? How they shoot using this? And they were using this to shoot this using those cannon. They even put together. And why in 20 years we had this? Maximum in 30 years we had completely different artillery systems, which looked like modern. Now, after 100 years, we still have the same artillery systems like we had before, 100 years ago. I mean, about 1,000 years ago, we were using bronze cannons with stone balls as cannonballs and so on. Why now we had absolutely everything changed in 20 years? I think we lost something. I think we lost technology we used to have before. And now we have something like this, even in our time. It's no way we could change technology, knowledges, materials, and everything. And ideology of using artillery. This term industrial revolution is a trick. We have capsule system, we have new loading system of loading and so on. And I think something changed. Why we did not think about something like this to use in cannons for 500 years at least? I think something is strange. Let's try to put one more part of the puzzle and put puzzle together. We see sometimes that bales and cannons were used together in some pictures. And we know that during the Battle of Bomarsund, real cannons, it was last time when old cannons were used. What we see here? We see, looks like we just pushed this wall. We didn't break it. Something like this. It reminds me something like this. wall made of boxes. That's what we see in Bomarzund, the same situation. No traces of hitting. It was just like pushed, like we saw before. Don't you think it's similar? Don't you think it's wrong analogy? And we definitely remember that we have traces of hitting, and we need this ball because in this machine without balls, no sparks. It will not work. Let's put the puzzle together. What happens if we put hit the box, simply the box with a hole, round hole on one side? That's what happens. Smoke cannon. But what if we hit something not rectangular, this shape? What will happen? We will have more vortex. Vortex.
As they slowly rise and cool, the water within the gas clouds condenses, revealing each ring shortly after it floats away from the plant.
It's the same.
Realities United designed a simple mechanism to create these rings. An elastic cylinder on the roof expands to store the plant's exhaust. When exactly a quarter of a ton of CO2 has filled the drum, a shutter opens and the drum suddenly contracts, expelling the gas into the sky.
That's why we need this flat edges. You still don't believe? Watch it happens. Watch what happens if we use right cannon. But I think technology was the same. We were making vortexes with energy, and that's why we need flat ending. And we see this vortex can survive and get even more power for long and work for long distances. 100 meters. What we see. It can be sustainable, I mean, even more powerful on long distances and very wide areas. I think it's realistic. You still don't believe it? You still don't believe in power of standing wave? Watch what happens. And if we had some energy, some static energy, which we had plenty of it, if we add that's free incredible energy and this mechanical vortex, that's why we need the stone ball, because crystals actually can send energy through. And even light, laser can send vibration throughout stop space. Or we will be forced to
fire upon you. It's called some laser, что логично, не может.
They use laser to send vibration, but why cannonballs with vortex cannot send vibration? Because everything is information. I think information can be sent, information can destroy huge granite walls. I think it's realistic. What do you think? Please write in comments. And thank you for your attention. I know I have weird ideas. Please write what do you think. I need it. Bye.